Video gaming parlors can bring crime, crowding, and traffic in local neighborhoods, but lawmakers have been trying to get rid of them and ban them for a decade. But right now, Charlotte has more of them than ever.
A judge in Onslow County will soon make a decision that will impact the entire state of North Carolina, whether the businesses are legal or if they're another form of gambling. Our reporter Mark Becker investigated how they managed to stay open and what's being done to keep them in check.
Teddy Pierce has been serving up pizzas at his place on W.T. Harris Boulevard for 14 years.
A couple things coming out, but we should be good.
Business is good. And so from the looks of it is business next door at the video gaming parlor that opened several months ago, along with three others, all within a mile of his place.
They're all silently going up, too. It's not just there. They're just popping up.
What Pierce and many others here can't figure out is how they're popping up 7 years after the state passed a law to prohibit sweepstakes machines, and just 4 years after the Mecklenburg County District Attorney's Office sent a letter to sweepstakes parlors here ordering them to close down or face criminal charges.
The DA deemed them unlawful. How did they get back in? What is the, what's going on?
Oh, yes. They're coming up fast.
Sergeant Chris Raines estimates there may be close to 100 now in Charlotte, most in lower-income neighborhoods, in what he calls a high-cash business.
I've been told that some machines make upwards of $1,200 a day, so you can imagine if they have 20 machines.
And all of that cash has invited trouble. Police have reported several robberies and shootings at those businesses this year, including one fatal shooting back in August.
How you doing? Nothing happened.
We went along as Detective Bill Murray checked on some of those new gaming parlors. We agreed not to show his face.
My name is Mark Becker. I work with Channel 9. How are you? We're riding with them, trying to find out about these businesses.
None of them would let our camera in, and no one working there would tell us who actually owns those businesses. But Detective Murray says police can't close them down because a restraining order filed in that case in Onslow County won't let them seize any machines until the judge there rules whether they're legal.
So there's really nothing you can do in a situation like that?
Right.
Frustrating?
A little bit.
And it's more than frustrating for some of the businesses close by.
It does get in the way. You know, constant parking. Some people would never leave. They would just overbearing. Just crazy.
But for now, police are handcuffed by a law that's on hold.
Keeps me from doing anything in regards to those machines.
Can't do anything about them.
No, sir.
In Charlotte, Mark Becker, Channel 9 Eyewitness News.
Now, Mark contacted the attorneys representing those video game distributors. One said they couldn't comment before the trial in Onslow County next month. In the meantime, a state senator from Catawba County is proposing limiting the number of machines in any one facility to four, even if the judge decides that they are legal.